We need to determine the absolute extrema on the closed interval from negative 1 to 4 of the given function. Now, absolute extrema are different from relative extrema, so let's start with a quick review. To determine the absolute extrema on a closed interval, we want to determine the largest function value and the smallest function value for all values of x in the interval. So one of the biggest differences between absolute extrema and relative extrema is that absolute extrema can occur at the endpoints of the closed interval. So to determine the largest and smallest function value, we'll have to evaluate the function at the critical numbers as well as the endpoints of the interval. Looking at this function on this closed interval, notice that the largest function value occurs at this point here at the endpoint. So this point here represents the absolute maximum on this closed interval. And notice how the least function value is negative 1 at x equals negative 2. So this point here represents the absolute minimum. Again, notice that it occurs at the endpoints. Now notice how these two points do represent relative extrema, but they are not absolute extrema because there are function values that are greater than this function value here, and there are function values that are less than this function value here. Now looking at the second graph, notice that this relative minimum here is also the absolute minimum because it is the least function value on this closed interval, but the absolute max would occur at x equals 6 with a function value of positive 5. So the idea here is to determine the absolute max and min, we do have to determine the function values at the critical numbers and the endpoints. So let's give it a try. So we'll start by determining the critical numbers of the given functions. So we'll determine the first derivative. Here we'd have x to the third minus 3x squared. And now we'll set this equal to 0 and solve. Greatest common factor here would be x squared, leaving us with the quantity x minus 3. So our critical numbers are x equals 0 and x equals 3. So now to determine the absolute extrema, we need to evaluate the function at these critical numbers, but also at the endpoints of negative 1 and 4. So the largest function value of these four will be the absolute max, and the least function value will be the absolute minimum. And to save some time, we're going to go ahead and evaluate the function using the calculator. I've already typed the function into y1, so we'll determine these function values from the home screen. We'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter. And now we can just enter in the x values in parentheses. So in parentheses we have 0, vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and we have 3. We also have negative 1 and 4. So notice of these four function values, the largest function value is 1.25, or 1 and 1/4. That's our absolute maximum at x equals negative 1. And the least function value is negative 6.75, or negative 6 and 3/4 at x equals 3. This will be our absolute minimum. So let's go ahead and record these function values. So again, the absolute max is 1.25, or 1 and 1/4 at x equals negative 1. And the absolute minimum is negative 6.75, or negative 6 and 3/4 at x equals 3. Let's go ahead and verify this graphically. Notice how I've graphed this function only on the interval from negative 1 to positive 4. The largest function value, which occurs here, is 1.25 at x equals negative 1, which is the absolute max. And then we had an absolute minimum of negative 6.75 at x equals 3, located here. So notice how the absolute max occurred at an endpoint, and the absolute minimum occurred at a critical number. This is why we have to determine the function values at both the critical numbers and the endpoints. I hope you found this helpful.